चित्र शाह, डायरेक्टर सत्या स्पेशल स्कूल चित्र। हाय चित्र, कनन वी आर मिसिंग यू। वेयर इज कनन? यस आई नो, आई सी यू कनन। आई सी एट द मोमेंट कनन, वेयर आर यू?
यस मैम।
अच्छा, ही इज नॉट ऑन द स्क्रीन बट ही इज अवेलेबल। Karthi, you've grown a beard.
I think she's talking to you.
Oh, ma'am. How are you, ma'am? I can hear you.
You've become a beard man.
Yes, because of the lockdown.
So the lockdown means long hair, is it? Huh? That's nice. Are you keeping well?
Ma'am, your voice is breaking, ma'am.
My voice is breaking, Mr. Tilak Ram. Mr. Tilak, my voice is not clear.
Not really, ma'am.
Yours is clear. Now they're muting the others to have the voice.
Yeah, better, ma'am. Now it's better.
Now it's
very clear.
We have muted the others. Okay, I will tell you who to connect to, unmute that person. So we have spoken to Anush, Ashok, we have spoken to Chitra.
Yes.
We have spoken to Kannan, I haven't seen yet. Say hello to Kannan. Bring Kannan. I saw him, but they are unable to bring him on the screen. Which platform is this?
Skype.
Why did you take Skype? Skype is not so good. Earlier ones were all much better.
One and a half years, ma'am.
Oh my God! As far as I'm concerned, we are stuck where we were. But good to see you. This was the only way. Asha is the one who floated the idea to connect with all of you.
Yes, ma'am, that's a great idea, ma'am, actually. She always having a great idea for us.
Yeah.
Because I sit behind ma'am all the time, so I invite.
Karthi Gyan Kulangal. Who's
Karthik?
Karthik. This is
Karthik.
Hello,
ma'am.
That is
hello, ma'am.
There are two Karthiks.
Yes, ma'am. This is
Vanakkam.
Srishti Karthik.
That's Srishti Karthik. And this is,
ma'am, he's the one who's working with the ponds and everything.
Oh, I see, he's the one.
Yes, Karthikan, and he's been doing a lot of pandemic assistance.
So where is our Karthik? Where is the other Karthik? Not Srishti Karthik. Not the dhari, not the beard man. Now give me non-beard.
So many others have gone there.
There's the other. Others are joking.
Yes, Monika ji is there.
I was just want to see कि मैं पॉन्डिचेरी की एनजीओस भी देख लूँ. जब मैंने एनजीओस पढ़ा तो I was interested.
All right, we have only these 9 we could accommodate on Skype.
Yes.
So I have Karthikeyan. Where is I Karthikeyan? Where is he? Show me his face. And then we have Purushar. SOS Village.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Namaste, good afternoon, good evening, ma'am. I am Purushar, SOS Children's Village.
I know, very good. Thank you so much, Purushar. I know, it's very
thank
good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Then Sarvanan. Sarvanan. Sarvanan, where are you, Sarvanan?
Here he is. Namaskar, ma'am. This is Sarvanan from Aranya Forest.
Very nice, Sarvanan.
Yeah.
Here.
After a long time, I'm in Hawaii. Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
So this is more today so to much. Say this hello to each time, other. And to find out that you are all healthy and fit.
Yes. Yes. I'm in I'm already quarantined. Like I'm living in Paris.
That's good. You are lucky that you are already in a green area, which is all
yes.
Lot of space, no social distancing required.
Yes, yes, I'm already a social distance.
Yeah.
Yeah. How are you, ma'am? You?
Doing well, managing.
Yes, thank you.
Sir. Managing and struggling.
You managing. Yeah, you. Welcome, ma'am.
So we got Shashikant also?
Yes, ma'am.
Where's Shashikant? Shashikant. I don't see Shashi joining, na?
No, he joined.
Shashi can't join now, he joined. Yes, Shashi. Then Vijayalakshmi of yes. Sanvi Education.
Yes, she
is. Now, what we do is give 3 minutes each to each one to speak.
Yes.
Bring one person at a time and ask them just what are they doing, how they're doing. Bring yes. one person and mute the others. Let them share one by one what they do, 2 minutes each. And those who are available, let's begin with them, those who are visible.
Ashok, unmute from again. We cannot hear you. Can you please unmute?
Huh? Let's begin with Srishti. Srishti, can you share with us in 3 minutes
yes.
what you're doing, how you're coping? Go ahead.
Very good evening. Very nice to meet you and thank you for this great opportunity to share our thoughts with you. This is such a great honor. So at Srishti we are doing very well and our school is functioning very well. And due to the lockdown, we closed our school. But the people who are living at Srishti village, they are doing well and living at Srishti village itself. As surroundings there, we are also quarantined ourselves actually. So we are living in our own form. And this is a great opportunity for us to work more intensely to work for the betterment of the people with the disability living at Srishti village. But what we noticed, people who are coming every day, the daycare children, most of the parents are the daily wages and due to the lockdown, they don't have any income to feed their children. So we started to support by providing the dry provisions, hand sanitizers, masks and everything. Then started in a small way, then almost we reached 1,000 families in Vilpuram and Pondicherry, especially for the children with the special needs, family who are affected due to the lockdown. And also what we realized, now some of the challenges we found, one, the COVID-19 guidelines is not accessible, especially for the people with hearing impaired or people with visually challenged. It's not accessible for them and still the challenges they are facing. And also what we realized, the children with a disability who are living in rural villages, and, I mean, people, they are affected with the epilepsy, they have to take regular medication, but unfortunately due to the lockdown and even the hospitals also not allowed anybody if they have any serious problem. So they are not getting regular medicine. So it was a big problem for them. If they stop one or two days, they get epilepsy. And we found many of them, they got affected. So we tried to reach as much as possible by providing the medicine. But still the challenge is existing, ma'am. So if we have any chances to address this issue, that helps. And on the way, we are also met many migrants, especially in Saidarapet. And I know Pondicherry government, they are very well organized to bring the migrant workers from Pondicherry to their native place. But yet we do not know the exact time of time or the buses available for the migrant workers. It's still challenging for them to get the information. And most of the information in English are in a local language and they know very well these people are from Bihar or from Uttar Pradesh or Bengal. So it's better if you have a chance to get in Hindi, that also helps. And still there are migrant workers we support through our network organization and they are facing the challenges. Well, that's some of our observation. But our biggest learning, we see now the families are very much bonded, especially in India, the children are mostly taken care by the mother. But now the father, due to the lockdown, forcefully they started to look after their children. Now they understand how biggest a challenge to look after a child with the special needs, and they started to look after them. They understand the mother challenges. These are all the very positive sign we see, and even the both mother and father and siblings started to look after them. This way we see the positive side of the lockdown also during this COVID-19. And as much as possible, we are supporting those people, and still we are continuing until the lockdown lifts. And thank you very much for giving this opportunity.
I think, say it again, I think you made a very good point regarding the fathers. Say it again, yeah. That fathers during the lockdown period are becoming more responsible. Can you say it again?
Yes, father has to take the responsibility to look after the children with the special needs, because until then they are always taking care of their business, but now they forcefully to look after their children, and now they understand how big the challenges are, how important to look after their children.
So you are saying the fathers of specially differently abled children are becoming more responsible, or have they understood?
Yeah. Are you saying right, that? Ma'am. You are right, yes ma'am.
Oh wow, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah, we have some unfortunate incident also happened. I think hope you read in the news in West Bengal, and one of the person with the intellectual disability person refused to wear mask, and the father get angry and hang him, and he killed his own son.
Now, my immediate response to your inputs, Karthi, is of Shrishti, is that Asha will make sure that whenever we get the inputs concerning COVID rules, SOPs, etc., we start sharing with all NGOs. We will forward these to you people as NGOs, so that you keep getting to know what are the Government of India guidelines coming time to time, which includes migrants.
Surely, ma'am. Yeah.
So whatever guidelines we will get hereafter will come to NGOs. We already have an NGO group.
Yes.
So they, Asha will send you, all of you, that means you stay up to date. Well, they are coming in English, but you can translate it as NGOs and pass it on to your other group members.
Surely, ma'am. That would be great.
We'll do that. But meanwhile, if you have any problem, you can put it back in the NGO group if you have a suggestion. Second thing is, what I notice is the need for mobile dispensaries.
Yeah.
The need for mobile dispensaries is made out, which is pretty good.
Definitely.
So two things are coming out of your interaction. All right. Now let's go to Chitra. Chitra of Satya Special School.
Yes, ma'am. In addition to what Karthik said, I think one of the biggest needs for the hour is mental health of the caregivers, especially if they are children with autism. Some of the mothers are facing very stressful situations because of their behavior, temper tantrums of the children. So we have started a psychiatric clinic, which is free and open to all. And we are like really loaded with a number of mothers who are contemplating committing suicide. So I think the lockdown was okay, but post lockdown, parents are unable to handle some of the especially adolescent children. So our focus now is on that. We are in touch with the Central Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. We're talking to them about an insurance scheme that is already available under the National Trust, where medicines of epilepsy and even psychiatric drugs could be available. The ministry is looking at it a little, positively.
And these drugs available.
Hopefully, they will add psychiatric counseling also for reimbursement. So that's quite positive as far as we are concerned. In addition to giving out relief, we also distributed toy kits to about 470 children, which are age specific, because we found children in the rural areas did not have anything to play with, and we were in our schedules always talking about play as a very good therapy. So this was something that was done, and I think was very beneficial to the children. Otherwise, I think we're just waiting to start. We don't know when, because therapy and children dependent on therapy is going to be a very, very important issue. The central government has issued guidelines on how we could give physiotherapy and speech therapy and how this could go forward. But we are still waiting for things to settle down. We don't want to rush into it. Our newborn high-risk clinic in Jipma is going through a bit of issues. Children who are born with disability in this lockdown period, generally we immediately intervene and provide services. That is kind of stopped, and these 6 months, the first 6 months of birth are very, very important. So we're trying to talk to Jipma to see what we could do. We also don't want to put the staff and the doctors at risk, but that's like a tricky situation. We've been discussing about it. Hopefully we'll find a solution. Otherwise things are fine going on and we are managing pretty well.
Are you connected with the collector who is in charge of these coordination of disaster management here? Are you all connected with the collector?
Yes, ma'am. We are constantly in touch with him.
Okay, we should connect them with the collector also.
Yes.
We'll connect you all with the collector also, so that you can also drop him a message if you need any such help. Okay? Okay, Chitra?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, Kanan, can I have you? Have your input? Kanan. Keep Puducherry clean. Kanan. Unmute Kanan.
Yes, ma'am?
Yes.
Yes, Kanan, carry on.
Good evening, ma'am. Actually, this lockdown is a very good thing for keep Puducherry clean. Actually, most of the coastal is very clean when compared to other days. So, these people who is going and sitting and throwing all this garbage, it is getting avoided due to this lockdown. And one more thing we could observe in this lockdown is people try to avoid usage of plastic. So getting this plastic materials, plastic bags, everything is, you know, in shortage during this time. So people try to take their own bag to purchase their materials and all. So it is actually very good for the environment. And one more serious thing we could observe in this lockdown is people who is using their mask, they are just throwing that in the roadside, you know, that is going to be a big thing. And you also mentioned that in several videos regarding this. And this is a serious thing, we have to look into that. And
we have to educate them. Education of mass
awareness. And then one more serious thing we observed in this thing is lack of people around our volunteers, around our planted areas. Because we planted plenty of trees in Bahur area, but we couldn't have the access to go and see how the plants were, saplings were, and we couldn't water it.
All the plantation volunteers in Bahur area.
So these are the problems we actually face during this lockdown, and we need to find out local
I will link you separate, Asha will link you Kanan, Asha will link you with the chief forest officer so that you can tell them, keep telling them what is going on. We have very good fine two officers, forest officers, link you with them. You can feed information directly to them.
And then one more thing is we could get plenty of calls from people asking how to have roof gardening in their house area, and they want to put terrace garden, and they need support from government also, because Panchay government is having some kind of subsidy schemes for this installing this roof gardens. So that also we can promote, because from Chennai itself we came to know that plenty of COVID cases reported due to the...
So we can ask Department of Agriculture, we can ask Department of Agriculture to do one lesson on cable, announce how do you do rooftop gardening.
Yes, ma'am, that will be better, ma'am, actually.
Yes, Pondi Doordarshan. We will make it through Pondi Doordarshan on rooftop gardening.
Yes, ma'am, that will be better, ma'am. And plenty of sessions, online session also they can conduct, so that people can come to know how to grow their own vegetables and all in order to avoid purchase from the markets.
Good. Any other suggestion, Kanan?
So these are the things, ma'am. And one more thing, still we are looking a lot of plastics are roaming here and there. So we can, we are enforcing plenty of things in this longer period, and it is better to insist our government to enforce plastic ban also very strictly, so that people who is already started avoiding plastic also will encourage this. So we can, and this will be
will appreciate non-use of plastic at the moment. We'll appreciate this. I'm also preparing my points for my Saturday, so this will help us.
Okay.
While we will take this in our video conference.
Yes.
Okay, Kanan, anything else?
Yes. Right now, no, ma'am. If there is anything, I will let you know.
Okay, thank you. Let's go to Saravanan of Aranya Forest.
Saravanan.
Namaskaram, ma'am. Once again. Due to the lockdown time, the view of my environmental view is really good for Aranya because too silent and more animals also now coming in an Aranya. And this year, too hot. That is the one problem because a lot of birds coming with my family only because we 1 month no allowed for any workers. My family only, we take care of all birds and animals. We given the water, but it's not such a enough for the birds because too much coming now. And we need more and more water. And also, still, also is not much
water. So are you saying, that the number of birds is increased?
Yes, ma'am. Now, which kind of birds are coming? Normally, January to February only coming.
So you are saying the birds have increased. Could you please tell us which birds?
More like local minas and silkurmi and the peacock. More and more sounding coming and very happy meaning because no sound, no. And I am very lucky because the lake estate is there and the Malbay is there. They are all very good area this way. And also to move to village also today. All pika and other things also going. The village people also sometimes is supporting the pika. This is really good way we see that environmental needs. But very unlucky, but it's too hot.
Are you in contact with our forest officers? Or if you don't have the contact, Asha will connect you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. And my daughter wants to talk something.
Good evening, ma'am.
Hi, good evening.
Yeah. In this lockdown, I have realized something. The pollution has gone down so much, and I've seen so many birds, like, from before, now there is more birds coming and also animals, and we go out to water plants and stuff, and we've been seed collecting, and my father has gotten so many calls from people asking for saplings because now in quarantine they want more trees near them. They realize the importance of trees now they've been at home, and I think that's a really important thing. And there's more people, they have online conferences and the job is done earlier, I think. More than meeting in real life, when you talk online, you can share more things and I think it goes faster. When you think, you just call them and then the job is done. So I think this is really nice. And now, it's really sad for me because now the virus is increasing, it's spreading really fast, but now only I see more people going outside, and gradually I see more people going outside because they're gaining like confidence, they won't get the virus. And I think that's not the way, like, that's not how it should be. People should be more, I think, they should have more awareness and avoid going outside. Even now with the quarantine's off, they should stay at home, I think.
Okay, Beta, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Sarvani. Thank you so much. Day before yesterday,
I addressing our water conservation, a small event in Coimbatore online. They are very happy that I'm saying that how to work to water clean up and how to water save and like that I'm teaching. And many conferences like that are going on. Even I'm working in Western Ghats also, communication. Day to day something happening is also. This is a very good contention to do many things now.
They have also noted the water is being cleaner, less pollution, less visitors. The water is clean.
Good. Thank you, Mr. Sarvanan.
Please come. Okay, ma'am.
Thank you. Let's go to Vijay Lakshmi, Sanvi Educational Charitable Trust. For the rest, you can mute.
Based on the data collected,
I don't see her. Vijayalakshmi, I don't see you.
Vijayalakshmi, can you on your video, please?
Switch on your video, please.
Vijayalakshmi, your video is off.
Okay, let's go to Ashok. Alright, let's go to Ashok, whoever is quickly available. Hi Ashok, carry on.
Good evening, thanks. Yeah, good evening ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Yeah.
Yeah.
You have decent 50 points, even during pandemic time, Ashok.
Yeah, recently we decented 2 points in this pandemic period, ma'am.
So you are a pond man?
Hello? Yeah, it's our duty, ma'am.
Very
With
good.
With all your support, we are really, my plan is to reach 100 pounds in this year. But due to this lockdown, we can't reach our estimate very short time. But I'm sure we will do my best to reach our 100 pound very soon, ma'am.
Let's save it this year again. Somehow save it with the, before the monsoons come. Let's keep our ponds ready.
Yes, ma'am. My current request, ma'am, recently I heard that Indian Oil Corporation requests permission for a pipeline in Usteri Lake, ma'am. Request a permission to land a pipeline project. So kindly please not allow for the project, ma'am.
Send us an email. Send us an email or a WhatsApp. Ashok, if you observe anything like that, send us an email.
Hello?
Ashok, if you observe anything like that, send us an email.
Yeah, sure, ma'am, because it's our very biggest water reach in Puducherry. We want to protect Usteri Lake, ma'am. Recently, we heard that, and I also give a news in News 18 also, ma'am, channel regarding this. I will sure send the article regarding the scheme, ma'am.
Whenever you observe something, any one of the NGOs like that, feel free to send us an email or a WhatsApp message.
Sure, ma'am. Then regarding online classes, ma'am, there is a difference between a private school and government school, ma'am. In private school, they are running online classes, but in government school, they are not. So the education nowadays is showing some difference between a rich and poor, ma'am. So please stop that online classes in private schools.
Mention me, send us the name of any government school children who are not getting this. Just mention the name, okay? Send us a WhatsApp.
Yeah, sure, ma'am.
We will link you with Secretary Education and Director Education. Let's link Ashok Kumar to Director Education.
Yes.
You let us know which school is losing out and let the Director Education find a way.
Sure, ma'am. Most of the private schools are doing the online classes, ma'am.
Okay. But you send us, if any government school like that comes to notice, we will see what Director Education should do to narrow the gap.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. All right, let's go to Ashok.
Sanvi has come. Sanvi has come.
Okay. Okay, Sanvi. Okay, Sanvi, can you please speak? Vijayalakshmi? Vijayalakshmi, she's still not with us. Okay, Venugopal, Ramalingam.
Sir, Vijayalakshmi, can you hear us?
Yeah, ma'am.
Carry on.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you for giving a wonderful opportunity to speak the elders' problem. Elders are not taking care of them. They are having a fear that COVID-19 will attack them. They don't have the food in time. The biggest savings have been already spent. Presently, they are not having money. They are in temple. In situation, they are not able to visit temple. They don't have a basic means to prevent COVID-19, like face masks and sanitizer. That's it, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Senior citizens also need a mobile. if they can, or they need a call center. They could call us a central helpline.
We have given in our women and senior citizen helpline. So
we need to make them aggressive. Make them active. There are senior citizens helplines of women and child. You need to promote it. You need to share the helplines to them.
Yes.
Share the helplines amongst NGOs. That's another area. These are the helplines. I think that will be going to our weekly Doordarshan message.
Yes.
These are very useful messages for Doordarshan. Excellent. Who else can be this who's online? Hmm? Who else do you want?
Mm-hmm.
We are. Yeah, Vandana Shah also.
Vandana Shah is there.
Let's talk to Vandana.
Vandana, where are you?
Yes, I'm here, ma'am.
Okay, Vandana. Can you hear
me, ma'am? Very good evening.
Good evening, Vandana.
Good evening, ma'am, and it's an honor for Sharana to be part of this interaction. Thank you.
Sharana.
So, Sharana works very closely with. Can you hear me, ma'am?
I can hear you very well.
So, Sharana works very closely with the street and slum communities in and around Pondicherry, and one of our main concerns has been, of course, hygiene and everybody living in such close quarters with each other. In March, we've been in constant contact with our beneficiaries with over 500 families, ma'am, over the phone. And our team of 10 social workers have been advising them and creating awareness about social distancing, hands washing, the importance of staying indoors. And our teachers have also tried to provide this an educational support to the children who have been missing school over the phone. And we waited till we had official permissions. And once we had official written permission from the collector's office, we started providing provision packets to the families that we work closely with, most of whom are red ration card holders, ma'am. And the kit consisted of rice, dal, rava, and in some kits also oil, masalas, and vegetables. And in total, we've distributed to about 800 families. And I'd like to note here that all good practices like wearing of masks, sanitizing of hands, social distancing, as well as zero contact distributions were kept in place. I'm very happy to share that Sharana was the only NGO that reached out to the 50 families of the Indra tribe, where we are working since more than 2.5 years now. In fact, this area of work was suggested by your kind office, ma'am.
They're still working there.
And in fact, at the Irula tribe, we provided provision items. We provided a larger list of items, and we provided them twice in the gap of 6 weeks because they really needed it. And also just wanted to bring to your attention that along with children's programs, we work closely with over 1,000 children. We also have a very dynamic project dedicated to the economic empowerment of underprivileged women in Pondicherry. And it's our social entrepreneurship program. And in the last 2 years, we have given micro loans to about 62 women from lower income groups to start their own small businesses. And goes without saying that, the women...
But you are aware of the Government of India schemes? You are aware of the vendors, Government of India schemes? They can take an interest-free, collateral-free loans.
Yes, absolutely, ma'am. And in fact, in the coming days, we plan to work alongside the state government with the schemes that the Honorable Finance Minister has announced for small scale entrepreneurs. So we plan to work along those lines. And they have had a hit because the businesses were small businesses, ma'am, and the income was day to day. And it took a big hit, but once the lockdown was lifted, many of the businesses have reopened, but their income is still only about 20%. From what it was pre-lockdown. One of the things that Sharana has tried to do is create awareness, and the other one is also to nurture the mental health also of the team and the people around. So to do that, we do art therapy with the staff of Sharana once a week, ma'am. And also mental health, like two or three others have shared. One is keeping children positively engaged. We try to have our role in that.
How did you
and
do it?
Also to keep
How did you do it?
So we've distributed activity kits, ma'am, which has paper, pens, and for painting. And our social workers and teachers follow up with the students and actually it's a family activity book.
So how did you do it? How did you do it? Did you go physically or connecting on the phone or how?
We had to do only the distributions physically, but otherwise all the instructions and all that were given over the phone. And the idea is to encourage that children emote, ma'am. So every day they are asked to draw something or paint something so that they or together as a family, they can, express what they are going through.
So
very often
you have been asking children to draw, which is like an expression of their emotion.
Yes, ma'am.
What
yes,
did
ma'am.
You see them drawing? What was their emotion so far?
Lost, angry, lack of space. Many of them complained that the television was on all the time. So we saw a TV, drawings. Some of them did report that the families came closer together. The fathers came around after a few weeks. But in many cases, the mother, who was already doing a lot of the work, landed up sharing a larger burden. So even though everybody was at home, the mother was the one who was working the hardest.
The work of the mother increased.
It did increase, yes. But there were some heartwarming stories of children coming together, helping the parents with the chores, or we are planning to do whose house is the cleanest competition to encourage the awareness of hygiene. So we are planning to give them a deadline and tell them to clean their homes. And that everybody has to participate, including the father, and then we are going to encourage between each other as to who can have the cleanest home, because many of them share community toilets, many of them share community taps. So the idea of hygiene and creating that awareness was a big challenge, ma'am.
Very nice, very lovely inputs. You've been very original. Is Monica online? I think Monica would be great.
Monica online.
Is Monica online? Bring Monica online. She's also an NGO and she's dealing with the children like that. Let's see if she's listening.
Okay. Yes, ma'am, I'm online.
Go ahead, Monica. Will you like to contribute what you are doing? I think the very interesting things which have come from Sharna, how they're making children emote through drawings and also clean house competitions.
Yes,
would you like to share? That's my NGO friends, by the way, India Vision Foundation. She's the director of the India Vision Foundation called Monica Dhawan. Monica, would you like to share?
Yes, hi. Good evening, everyone. So, since we are working with the children of prison inmates, so our role is to work with them. And since I was hearing all of your sharing, and similarly, we are also working with the children. So, we are involving them to engage with their mothers and fathers. And we are helping them with do small kind of plantations. So we do a small video kind of, we make small videos and share to them through WhatsApp of planting using small cups which they usually have in their house and how they can do small planting thing. They are helping their parents also in daily work also, and also engaging them through various story sessions. So storytelling session is one of the things which is very much liked by the children also, because this way it's a very interactive story session where we share one story with them and we discuss on that story. So that is very keeping them engaging also with everyone. So these are few of the things which we are also doing with our children.
And you also supplied provisions to many people, like the Shishti people were saying with the children. How did you do that?
So, since our beneficiaries are from a very, very different background, so the major need which was coming was providing of them provisions for ration. So, these were the utmost need, and which we are providing them regularly. And what we have done, so during lockdown in Delhi, we can't travel also because Delhi, the situation is different. So what we find out the solution was that the people were going to their grocery, nearby grocery shop, and they were taking that material from their grocery shop, and we were paytm the money to the grocery people. So we find out a solution. We again find out an innovative way where we were not able to go and give the ration, but we found out the solution to a problem.
Excellent.
So we did paytms and we did whatever which is needed
to reach out to this difficult time was finding out solutions. So that is how we do by using Paytm, Google Pay and other ways, so that the money is not given directly, but they were availing the ration thing directly through these measures.
Perfect.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. She volunteered, she was not invited, friends, but they got to know we are talking to you, and my foundation also from Delhi joined you. Thank you, Monica, for joining. Keep on the listening watch while we go to others also. Nice to see you.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Let's go.
Shashi.
Shashi Kant,
you're
here, I see you.
Good evening, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yeah, very.
Good evening, ma'am. I'm not from the NGO. It's the first time I'm here. And there's no formal training for me, but there is a lot of interest within me to do some work.
Another volunteer.
Amazing
volunteer, always ready.
62 days of feeding people. Yes.
He's done 62 days of feeding.
66.
Carry on, Shashi. How did you do it? Please explain and share.
Yes, ma'am. And ma'am, when this pandemic has started and there was a lockdown on 24th of March, then all of a sudden it struck to my mind that this is going to last at least 2-3 months. Then immediately I had some money which has been drawn from the GPF account for the marriage of a relative and to purchase land. Then I said, this is the right time to use this money. And I started my work with that. And I took up this counseling one. Apart from the counseling, what I thought, because only counseling is not enough, we have to go to the ground level and help the people. So I thought this cooperation, collaboration, and collective responsibility is the need of the hour. So along with, then I got associated maybe the number of organizations, some of the organizations are here. I'm very happy to see them. One is the Sanvi Educational Trust, with whom we took up the grocery we sent to the elderly people, and nearly 500 people have benefited out of that. Then we created a WhatsApp group where nearly 72 elder people within Pondicherry were benefited with getting the medicines, ma'am. Then we also understood that there are a lot many poor students within the educational institutions, those are unable to get any food. So we contacted them through the college faculties, and could see that they're very tough to get their meals made. So we have identified the poor student those, and some nearly 75 to 85 students were benefited out of that. And then I talked to Mr. Narayan Samu, who is the president of the Parent Teacher Association, with whom I have took up the sanitary, for the sanitary workers, health workers. So we have provided nearly 250 kits to them. Then we also took up the aspect of the feeding to the stray animals. Then I also got in association with the Srishti Foundation, Mr. Karthik. Then with them also we did little bit of grocery pack and vegetable pack. Then I got collaborated with the Puducherry State Fauna Welfare and Protection Federation. Then Mr. Badrinath is there, and we took the initiative of feeding stray animals for 4 weeks. Then there was Mr. Arusu, who was having a prime touch. Am I audible, ma'am?
I want to feed stray animals. Karthik and connected.
Hello.
Carry on.
Am I audible?
Yeah, very much.
Yes, ma'am. Then Mr. Arasu, who is an employee in Pondicherry University, with whom who is running a prime trust, that is Prime Educational and Charitable Trust, with him we have got associated for physically handicapped and challenged persons. And along with that, we provided grocery kits. Then I thought we are having a college canteen, which is not operation for the last 2 months. So the people those are engaging over there, they were remaining idle. So I thought taking the help of those people, and available resources, then we started feeding to the people in and around Puducherry, and which was included the White Town. There are a lot many beggars who are not getting food and all. So that continued for 10 days. Then 43 days we have associated with the Sanvi Educational Trust, where nearly 6 villages have been attended. Then on an average 100 aged people were taken care, and we continued for 43 days now. Then we took off the 1 day for the farmers on an experimental basis, because
what
they
do you mean by, what do you mean when you say we, what does it mean by we?
We means I was the, ma'am, I was taking care, and the help of some of my colleagues as well as some of the people those are in abroad, because they could see my things in my Facebook account, and they volunteered themselves. Shashikant, do you require any sort of help? Can you help us?
Because you got help from your abroad. Friends.
So yes, friends and some of the few alumni.
Excellent.
And And ma'am, I just, you know, today it is almost 65th day of my servicing to giving food. And I did not ask a single penny to anyone, but in fact, they have been volunteering themselves to help me.
Super.
So what I, and what I did, ma'am, then we took up the farmers on an experimental basis, because the farmers, those who are coming from far off places, they used to start by 5 o'clock and 4 o'clock. And they reach here by 7 and 8 without having any breakfast. And they used to get their lunch only when they reach the home. So we thought, why not start it? Then we thought of giving the farmers, then that is under the process. Then we took almost the sanitary workers, almost 3 days, ma'am, in Muscat area. And now I have taken another one which for the last 10 days near Rajiv Gandhi Hospital and Jipmer.
Yes,
near Rajiv Gandhi Hospital. Ma'am, may I continue, please?
I said, second.
Hello.
Carry on.
Yes, ma'am. For the, then while distributing the food, we did not restrict only. We also put in the awareness program. Whoever is getting the food, we are telling them, wear your mask, maintain a social distance, because giving a free food is very easy and they will be lining up. But we always the time maintain that they should maintain a social distancing, because the message of free, you know, S has to be taken off. So that was carried on, ma'am. So today we have reached the 65th day of this food servicing, and nearly 11,500 meals were served in this 65 days, ma'am. But needless to say, that what is missing, this is not everyone, Sashikandas, along with Sashikandas, so many people have been involved, but educational institutions are 100. And, but I'm hardly seeing any of the educational institution coming forward in the large scale. And because of that, ma'am, I could see that now the Good News Network, which is running, it's a social network in the USA, it is from California, they have recognized the services. And there's a Posse News which has also taken off my activities. And the local TV news, you know, on a regular basis, they've been taking of this case, ma'am. So what I feel, yes, ma'am, along with that, I did not stop it. I thought the Chief Minister's Relief Fund has to be also given. So I given something to the Chief Minister's Relief Fund, that is my personal amount. And to the Prime Minister's Healthcare Fund also, I have donated, because this is the time where everyone, irrespective of anything, they should come forward and help. Because if this is not the time, then there will not be any other time. And keeping a you know, balance on the bank account, I don't feel this is the right time, ma'am. So I thought I will take up this aspect, and this is how my things are going on. But I just felt like this is my, you know, feeling, ma'am. There are 100 educational institutions, and ma'am, 27th April, Honorable Education Minister, Government of India, Mr. Ramesh Pokhrelji, he has taken a conducted meeting where he has ensured that, you know, this is the Prime Minister message, where every educational institution should try to feed the poor people, and which is the need of the hour, which has been taken up by me, and for which a report has been sent to the MHRD, a copy I sent to Honorable LG office, ma'am, for just for information. And to me, ma'am, I just feel, you know, since I'm from the education background, this educational institution, they should be held accountable and responsible to do such type of work. And there should be a designated, you know, person to verify the reports, because we are initiating so many things, but somewhere we are missing out and we are not able to take up the call of action. That is where I feel it, ma'am. So, in fact, we have this inverse social responsibility, but it's very, very sad to say that in the last 65 days, I have not come across a single circular by anyone saying that, okay, we have an inverse social responsibility, let us do this thing. So, these are the things which I felt I will bring to an honest man.
Hello, ma'am. Thank you, Shashi. Thank you so much. We go to the next. Thank you so much, Shashi. I'm really proud of your work.
Thank you, ma'am. Absolutely. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Is that next?
From HelpAge India.
Okay, great. Venugopal. Mr. Venugopal.
Good evening,
Mr. Venugopal.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the great opportunity, ma'am. Actually, since March 21st, our helpline counselor team, helpline team is calling the elders and making awareness about the COVID-19, ma'am. So, daily they are making elderly people. So we are doing, and also we are distributing survival kit, family survival kit in more than 2,500 families, ma'am. And in Bagur and Netapakam, we have 250 elder self-help group, ma'am. So through the self-help group, we made awareness to all the elderly people. But in our concern, ma'am, actually, June 15th is the World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. So HelpAge India has taken a survey from the elderly people. So there are that I will forward that report, ma'am. HelpAge India, nationwide HelpAge India report that I will forward to Honorable NG office. So here we observed, ma'am, in the rural area, in rural people, they are not aware of the mask and this social distance, ma'am. So in banks also there are a lot of crowds. So our request is, so that this banks can allot 1 hour time for the elderly people, specifically for the elderly people, only for elderly people, so they can maintain social distance and also it is a benefit to elderly people, ma'am.
You can don't centralize the bank. The banks are very decentralized, the ATMs are decentralized. The moment you make it one, then others, it's better to read, but give them help.
Many of the elders are taking through Aadhaar card only, ma'am. Through Aadhaar card, they are taking only Aadhaar card. But at that time, they can specifically they can fix for elderly people. The other thing is, ma'am, the elder self-help group, actually our rural development organization is giving loan to the women self-help group, but the elderly self-help group also to be recognized, ma'am. The last 5 years they are taking loan from NAPFID. NAPFID has given loan for the second rotation, so but our banks are reluctant to give loan, ma'am. So that also we request from our side.
Send me a little note which you feel so I can send it to the bankers.
Yes, ma'am.
Send Asha your little concern, and okay, then we'll link you with the banker. We'll link you with the lead bankers here.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Thank you. Yes,
go ahead.
Next one. Rendu per Pushoth and Kartikeya.
Last one? Then we have Pushoth
from SOS.
And anybody else there?
Okay, yes, yes. Good evening, ma'am.
Hey, Pushar.
I'm Pushar, SOS Children's Village.
Yes, right.
And thank you, ma'am, for giving us opportunity to share our present situation during lockdown. We are having 120 children at present, and 15 mothers who are taking care of them, and we ensuring that all the children are getting nutritious food and proper care. So because children are not going to school, it is very big challenge to manage them, ensure their mental health, physical health, and the situation is that we are not allowing anyone to come inside the gate, and not allowing any children and child or mother to go outside. All the grocery and vegetables are coming on the gate, and mothers are collecting. And we are also engaging all the children in the evening. They are playing, they are dancing, and we are ensuring the hygiene of the children and campus. Disinfection has been done, and medical checkup also has been done. So all children are healthy, and they are doing fine. Sometimes they are feeling frustrated, and they are showing their anger, and they are fighting to each other. These kind of challenge we are facing here, but anyhow we are managing.
From
120 children.
Very difficult to explain.
Deep mistreated.
His place of connectivity is poor, he said, no, because he is far away. He told us in the morning. But it is Bella to say.
Yes. To, yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes,
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Do you want to ask any question, ma'am?
No, I think we're very happy. I know you're very well, organized, and you're protecting the children so well. We know that you are a institution by yourself. So thank you for looking after the children so well.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Vikram,
yes.
Last one?
Yes, last. Kartik.
Kartik. Well, who's that? Last Kartik.
These are migrant workers for khana khanana or what he's been doing.
Let's go to Kartik.
Yes. Kartik and Gajendran.
Not there?
He was there.
But all of you are all connected. You are getting to hear what we are doing. You are getting to see. But we'll share with you whenever time to time Government of India instructions come. You are all connected with Asha, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
So Asha will communicate a little more with you on any time we get Government of India instructions. And we can be linking you with the concerned officials so that you can ask direct help. Asha and I are anyway standby for you. But we'll link you with the collector and forest officer, the others which I think have been observed, social welfare, so that you can directly also work. Women helpline, these are all very important lines. So we will stay connected, but you are open to send us a WhatsApp message. As you know, you're getting a lot of traffic from our side. You can also send us a message.
Thank you so much for the great opportunity, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Stay connected. We will go to the second installment of NGOs also, because they're also looking for. So another day we will do the second lot of NGOs. We'll stay connected, but we picked up some very valuable points from you. Need for a mobile dispensary, need for mobile counselor available, psychiatrist. I think we got some ideas in our video conferencing this evening with secretaries. I will point out these. Also, every Saturday we do a recording for Doordarshan for Sunday morning. We will raise these issues. Inform the people. Okay? Thank you.